1 PM Pakistan Standard Time. Assalamu alaikum. This is Radio Pakistan. The news read by Sukaina Abbas. First, the headlines. Police Martyrs Day is being observed today to pay homage to services of police personnel. Prime Minister has paid rich tribute to police personnel for sacrificing lives to safeguard public and their property. Pakistan witnessed a remarkable surge in exports during current financial year due to concerted efforts of Special Investment Facilitation Council. Israeli forces martyred 3 more Palestinians in strikes on Al-Aqsa Martyrs Hospital in Gaza today. And now the news in detail. Police Martyrs Day is being observed today to pay homage to services of police personnel. The day aims to honor brave policemen of the nation and express solidarity with their families. Special functions will be held across the country to appreciate sacrifices of police force for establishing peace. Prime Minister Mohammad Shehbaz Sharif has paid rich tribute to the police personnel who have sacrificed their lives to safeguard the public and their property. In his message on the occasion of National Police Martyrs Day, the Prime Minister praised the police for their unwavering commitment and crucial role as the frontline defenders in the fight against terrorism. Highlighting the bravery of the police, the Prime Minister highlighted their continuous sacrifices in securing a better future for the nation. He assured that the federal government is dedicated to supporting the families of these martyrs, particularly in the areas of education and health for their children. Yom-e-Istisal will be observed tomorrow to lodge strong protest against India's illegal and unilateral action of August 5, 2019. This was decided at a special meeting chaired by Prime Minister Shehbaz Sharif in Islamabad to review preparations for Yom-e-Istisal. The meeting approved a main event to be attended by Pakistani and Kashmiri leadership. The Prime Minister is expected to visit Muzaffarabad to express solidarity with the Kashmiris tomorrow. He would strongly condemn the unilateral and illegal steps of India on August 5, 2019. The Prime Minister would also issue an important policy statement. On the Yom-e-Istisal, special walk would be held and events would be organized at the federal level in all provinces as are Jammu and Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan. In the state capital Muzaffarabad, documentaries about illegal, unconstitutional and immoral steps taken by India on 5th August 2019 will be shown on big screens in major cities of AJK. Yom-e-Istisal is observed as a special day against India's illegal action of August 5, 2019 to end the special status of Jammu and Kashmir and support Kashmiris in their struggle for right to self-determination. On this day, the Jammu and Kashmir dispute, basic rights violations of Kashmiris and the broken promises of India would be highlighted. Special transmission Radio Pakistan will broadcast to shed light on the efforts of the leadership of the Kashmiri Freedom Movement, sacrifices of Kashmiris and the facts about Indian oppression. Pakistan has witnessed a remarkable surge in exports during current financial year due to concerted efforts of Special Investment Facilitation Council. According to the data released by the Pakistan Bureau of Statistics, Pakistan's merchandise exports rose by 10.54% to $30.64 billion in financial year 2023-24. The imports fell 0.84% to $54.73 billion. With the round-the-clock efforts of the SIFC and the Ministry of Commerce, new markets of Jordan, Uzbekistan, Lebanon and Egypt have been opened for export of meat. For the first time in history, Pakistan's agro exports increased by 37% from $5.8 billion to $8 billion. By reaching this level of development, Pakistan's agriculture sector can achieve export target of $10 billion in current financial year. Repatriation of illegal Afghan nationals continues and so far 675,190 Afghans have returned to their country. Between 21st of July to 3rd of this month, a total of 15,537 Afghans returned to their country. President Asif Ali Zardari has summoned session of the Senate at the Parliament House in Islamabad at 5 p.m. tomorrow. National Assembly will also resume its session at 11:30 in the morning tomorrow. Three Palestinians were martyred and over a dozen others injured in Israeli strikes on Al-Aqsa Martyrs Hospital in central Deir al-Balah in Gaza today. The martyrdom toll of Palestinians in Israeli aggression on Gaza since October 7 last year has now risen to over 39,500. And that is the end of the news. For more news and analyses, log on to our website radio.gov.pk and also watch live video streaming of our bulletins on the link Radio Pakistan News Official.